We have just launched an ambitious initiative to restore 60 reefs and 60 sites across Australia in the next 6 years. That's kind of what success means for us in the medium term. Success today for the Nature Conservancy is to ground truth. This habitat suitability modelling is to find a suitable site for shellfish reef restoration and to bring back a lost ecosystem. Up to 50% of the bay was once dominated by shellfish reefs. They're no longer there. The way in which we build shellfish reefs, we use a combination of limestone rubble and recycled shells. We source those recycled shells from seafood wholesalers and restaurants. We have recycled around 1,000 cubic metres, which is around 275 tonnes of shells, which would have otherwise ended up in landfill. The sites that we've chosen have been based on some habitat suitability modelling. So it's a site that we consider, at least on paper, would be suitable for shellfish reef restoration around depth as well. But we're going out there today, we're going to dive the site, we're going to do an observational dive to check it out, take some photos, gather for some further evidence before we make the final decision. We want a bottom that has evidence, potentially, of shellfish reefs. Ideally, there's current that sort of brings the nutrients through on a regular basin. You need a certain amount of salinity in the water for these shellfish to survive. There is a bunch of different shellfish or bivalve species, abalone and scallops, for example, but whilst abalone and scallops will grow in abundance together, they don't cement together to create a reef. It's their oysters and mussels that all grow on top of each other over time, accrete in size and create a living, breathing reef. At the moment, the reefs are like a pimple on a pumpkin. There's 2.5 hectares spread over 2 sites, but it's not much. We're looking to build another 20 hectares in the next 3 years, which you really will start seeing some big differences. Restored shellfish reefs produce on average 375 kilos of new fish into the system. So recreational, commercial, important fish species, so improve that. Also provides habitat and home to a bunch of other different smaller species like snapping shrimp. Some of the cryptic species like hula fish, pygmy, leather jackets. Not only in fish production, but also in terms of water quality. Bivalves are filter feeders. They clean the water. So an average oyster can filter around a bathtub of water per day. So it's exciting that such a small footprint, there's big differences. The bigger that footprint, the bigger differences you're gonna see.
Can you imagine what we've been there, hey? With yeah. Some size of these oysters. So.
It's an old shellfish reef, and I think the shells sort of proves that. Looks like good potential. It's kind of exciting how you'd be able to actually build the patches in the proper places around here, and you could turn it back into a thriving ecosystem.
Yeah, totally.